everybody. Welcome back to Howling Moon Studios. It's a lovely day here in Northern California, and I am very excited to be playing. Want you to know that around here, you know, we have been trying to stay sheltered in place to stay well, because there is a lot of virus in California. It's worse down south than it is up here, but it's a lot worse up here than it was only a month ago. So being super careful is our program right now. Anyway, I've got a whole bunch of songs, but I'm gonna play a bunch of things that just for whatever reason really appealed to me today, including a whole bunch of things from when I was growing up. This one, however, is this is Forget. Through a hotel window, arena swaying wild, gentle swells and harbor smells, afternoon and night, voices from the cafe table, soundtrack for their life. She dreamed he'd be a memory soon, he dreamed she'd be his wife. Said, I think you're lovely. He said, you always glow. He said, you thrill me like no other, and forevermore. He said, you take my breath away. You're perfect, this I know. She turned to him and said, I'm glad you think so. Turns to evening, evening turns to night. Heartbeat slows and traffic flows, artificial light. Voices from the street below, voices in his head. And from a dream she stood before him, this is what he said. He said, you always glow. He said, it thrill me like no other, and forevermore. He said, take my breath away. You're perfect, this I know. She turned to him and said, I'm glad you think so. Said, I'm glad you think that I'm as perfect as can be. I only wish I saw in you the things you see in me. With that she turned and left him standing by the door. And London did disappear and echo forevermore. He said, you know you're lovely, you know you always glow, you know you thrill me like no other, and forevermore. You know you take my breath away, you're perfect, this I know. In his head she said, glad you think so. In his head she said, I'm glad you think so. In his head she said, I'm glad you think so. I want to send this one out to Anne. to lead a better life. I need my love to be here, making each day of the year, changing my life with the wave of her hand. Nobody can, now that there's something there, running my hands through her hair. Each one born thinking that good it could be, somebody speaking, she doesn't know he's there. I want her everywhere. When she's beside me, I know I need never care. To love her is to need her everywhere. Knowing that love is to share. Each one believing that love never dies. Watching her eyes, hoping I'm always there. I want her everywhere. When she's beside me, I know I need never care. To love her is to need her everywhere. Knowing that love is to share. Each one believing that love never dies. Watching her eyes, hoping I'm always there. To be there and everywhere. Here, there and this next song I haven't performed very many times, but I'm going to perform it a lot more because it really fits the moment. It's really a song about what it means to be someone who is on the pointy end of the white patriarchy. Somebody who is in some way cast as other and therefore not valued by society, or at least by some portions of society, the way that they deserve to be valued. And I wrote it a couple years ago, but I could have written it yesterday and it would I'd feel good about it then. It's called 555.
Born in a village south of the border, brought here when she was three. Always in shadow, she got into college, worked hard, and earned a degree. 5:55 Monday, sirens in the distance, nightmares intruding again. Emotions all tangled, will they depart her? Felt worse, but doesn't know when. Heading to work, Vicky is driving, Leon does time in the pen. He got pulled over, a roach and one tail light, they sent him up river for 10. 5:55 Tuesday, police lights are flashing, putting her over this time. What will the charge be? She worries out loud, is driving while black still a crime. Whoa, another day's coming. Small steps are better than none. Whoa, another day's coming. all of us acting as one. Under a rainbow outside Laredo, two young men living in sin have their own bedrooms, pretend to be roommates, dancing on the head of a pin. 5:55 Wednesday, somebody's been snooping, spray painted threats on a wall. Can't help but see it, they fear to fight it, caution's 9/10 of the law. Whoa, another day's coming, small steps are better than none. Whoa, another day's coming, all of us acting as one. Tend your own garden, let me tend mine, live and let live every time. People believe what they believe, that should be okay with you. You believe what you believe, doesn't mean I believe too. Madison wrote it, let's try to live it, the playing field favors a few. Let's join together, forward together, it's true. Whoa, another day's coming, small steps are better than none. Whoa, another day's coming, all of us acting as one. Whoa, another day's coming, small steps are better than none. Whoa, a better day's coming, all of us acting as one.
This chart I have in my iPad tells me I wrote this song on, I finished on the 23rd of November of 2016, which means I wrote it immediately after the election. And these are all the people I was worried about. And it turns out that wasn't the half of it. That was certainly the front end of it, but it's gotten so much worse. Now I got a word for everybody. I mean, I think it's amazing. Today we got the news, right, that, you know, Trump's not going to have a in-person convention in Florida, in Jacksonville. But he still wants all the kids to go to school. And it's like, logical consistency is not highly prized at the moment. I mean, I understand the argument. I mean, obviously there are issues of social development. There's obviously issues of just having meals. All of those things are really important about schools. We can take care of the food part, even without sending kids to class. But there are very few schools in America that are set up for distance learning, you know, for people being spread out social distance. So I don't know how that's going to work. What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I try not to sing out of key. Oh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get by with a little help from my friends. Gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away? Does it worry you to be alone? How do I feel at the end of the day?
Are you sad because you're on your own? No, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get by with a little help from my friends. Gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? Somebody to love. Would you believe in a love at first sight? I'm certain that it happens all the time. What do you see when you turn out the light? Can't tell you, but I know it's mine. I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. Gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I need somebody to love. Oh, get by with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I get by with a little help from my friends. A little help from my friends.
So this next one I wrote just before we recorded the most recent Full Moon Alice album. And if you haven't checked it out, on moonalice.com, we are giving you the chance to download the first six songs, which is a third of the album. We'll probably keep putting out songs because there's no point in putting out an album, so we might as well just give them to you. Anyway, this is one that I wrote with Chloe Teaching. And it's derived from a line in one of Chloe's songs that's also on the album. And I just thought that this notion was so cool, I was gonna write a whole song about it.
Santa Ana winds blow and the hills catch fire. The town burns up like a funeral pyre. No matter what happens, no matter what fails, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. It was a bad day at work in the blistering sun. You busted your butt and the job is no fun. Pickup got towed, they made you eat kale. At least your dog is waiting and wagging its tail. Whoa, no, no matter how bad, you may be angry or you may be sad. The one thing you can count on when you get out of jail, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. You drive for Lyft all day and Uber all night. Then you fall asleep at a traffic light. When you finally go home to a bottle of Vell, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. Whoa, no, no matter how bad, you may be angry or you may be sad. The one thing you can count on when you get out of jail, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. You're feeling alone, there's nowhere to go. You wanna move fast, but they make you move slow. Just one cure that never fails. It's a doggy that's waiting, a doggy that's wagging its tail. Santa Ana winds blow and the hills catch fire. The town burns up like a funeral pyre. No matter what happens, no matter what fails, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. Whoa, no, no matter how bad, you may be hangry or you may be sad. The one thing you can count on when you get out of jail, your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. Your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail. Your doggy will be waiting and wagging its tail.
You know, this whole thing of social distance has been super hard on the band, right? I mean, we've been together, you know, for 13 years. And, you know, we've spent a lot of time together. And this is the longest we haven't been together since the thing started. And, you know, I mean, John wasn't there right at the beginning, but he was there within 2 years, right? So he's been there more than a decade. And, you know, obviously it's been more recent with Lester and Dylan and the T-Sisters. But, you know, they're family. And so not getting to see them. I mean, we do get to see Chloe, Jason and I do. But, you know, this is really hard. And, I mean, we really want to play together, but obviously we have several people in the band who are at risk. And so, you know, an abundance of caution, Moon Alice is laying low. But that doesn't keep me from thinking about everybody. So one of the things I got going in this set is I got songs that other members of the band would normally sing. I got two of them. And this is one that the only times Moon Alice has played this song, Barry has sung it. And it's such a cool song, and I've been encouraging Barry to use the downtime to work on his singing, because he has a beautiful voice, and he just, for whatever reason, shy about it. And I just think that we need to get him singing more. Speaking of getting together, tomorrow, Friday, we're having a very special second show. Well, we had two last week, you know, because of that festival. We did an afternoon and evening show, but we had one Tuesday, and then we're going to have one tomorrow, of the quartet. And so that's a good thing. And I think if the quartet winds up, if it's possible to get everybody's schedule, we'll try to do more of that, because it surely is fun, and it's exciting to play outdoors, and the neighbors like it, and so, you know, all of that seems like it's pretty cool. And then Saturday, we're not going to play Saturday. Saturday, we're yielding, if you will, the airwaves to our friends in Los Lobos. So Hardly Strictly Bluegrass is doing a launch event, which will be a live show. So it's not a tape thing or anything. It's a special show of Los Lobos just for Hardly Strictly Bluegrass. And we'll be using our infrastructure. So you can watch it on the Hardly Strictly Bluegrass website, or you can watch it on Lunales.com, DDSband.com, and obviously YouTube, Twitter, etc. And we hope you'll watch it. That's at 4 p.m. Pacific time on Saturday. I hope you'll watch that, because that will be a fantastic event. You know, it's a privilege to be able to, you know, share music with people. And it turns out it's pretty cool just to share, like, live streaming infrastructure with people. Right? Because variety is the spice of life. And, you know, we, as some of you know, we've broadcast Los Lobos shows before. And they're amazing. And it's always fun when they're on our network. So this next song, I wrote after Hurricane Sandy. And it's really the story of Lunales being in Brooklyn when Hurricane Sandy hit, and how the band was able to get out of town, but the crew and all the poster artists, because we've been having a poster show at the Brooklyn Bowl the day that Sandy hit, they all got left behind. And I always felt terrible about that. I mean, in the end, it was okay. Chris and Chuck Sperry were lucky, because the band and poster artists, the crew and poster artists, were in a hotel in Midtown Manhattan, directly across the street from the building where that crane collapsed. And Chuck and Chris were, two of our poster artists, were walking down the street when the crane collapsed. Fortunately, because of the building that had construction, they had those things you see in New York where they have a scaffolding with a ceiling over their head. But they were just at the opening of it when the pieces were falling down, all the pieces of I guess it was cement or granite or something. And they were ricocheting off the pavement. And Chris's leg got cut up quite badly. But fortunately, you know, no permanent damage. Anyway, I wrote this song. It's called Last Chopper Out of Saigon.
Saw it coming from a thousand miles, with every hour it grew. An epic storm marking time, that crawled before it flew. We shed a million, you and me, telling stories naturally, making light of danger we both could see. When signs turned into warnings, I made my getaway. You stayed behind, faking brave as blue skies turned to gray. And then the sky came crashing down, the oceans rose from underground. I was feeling safe, but all alone on the last chopper out of Saigon. I was among the lucky ones who made it out that day. I hitched a ride on Noah's Ark, I never thought to stay. The city disappeared below, then creeping dread began to grow, for friends I left behind in my rush to go. When the signs turned into warnings. I made my getaway. You stay behind, fake and brave, as blue skies turned to gray. And then the skies came crashing down, the oceans rose from underground. I was feeling safe, but I'm unknown on the last chopper out of Saigon. Will I get another chance to prove myself to you? To prove myself to you. Stone ripped through your city, homes and lives destroyed. Neighborhoods were blown away as if by an asteroid. I waited for some word from you. I held my breath till I turned blue when the good news came my side and finally knew. When signs turn into warnings, next time I will not run. We'll stay or go together. We'll face our fate as one. Then the skies come crashing down, the oceans rise from underground. We'll all be on, or no one's going on the last chopper out of Saigon. We'll all be on, or no one's going on the last chopper out of Saigon. On the last chopper out of Saigon.
So, when I was first learning to play guitar, I had a friend whose father was like a senior guy in the RCA record club. You probably don't even know what record clubs are, but when I was a kid, a record club was a thing that offered you a deal where you could get 3, 4, 5, 10 albums for $1. And then you had to buy a few every single month after that. And this guy, his father had been like super senior guy in the RCA record club, which meant that he had every single LP that came out, and he would sell them for like $1 a piece. And you know, you think to yourself, well, who's on RCA? Well, Jefferson Airplane and Hot Tuna were on RCA, so from my perspective, that worked just fine. So, you know, when I had like one album each of most of the bands I liked, I had literally everything by the Airplane and Hot Tuna. And, you know, one of the albums I got super early on, because it was a brand new album, was a Hot Tuna album called First Pull Up, Then Pull Down. And I had no idea what that meant in those days, because I'd never seen a toilet seat cover, right? That's where you see that. And, but apparently they had, and that's what this album was called. And the first song on it just really caught my attention. Father, keep right on praying. Mother, don't stop praying, for this old witch is almost done. Now keep your lamps trimmed and burning, keep your lamps trimmed and burning, keep your lamps trimmed and burning, for this old witch is almost done. Now sister, don't stop singing. Sister, don't stop singing. Sister, don't stop singing, for this old witch is almost done. Now keep your lamps
Trinidad burning, keep your lives. All this old witch is almost done. Mother, don't stop preaching. For this old world, she's almost done. Now keep your lamps trimmed and burning. Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. Keep your lamps trimmed and burning. For this old world, she's almost done. Is keep your lamps trimmed and burning, keep your lamps. Trimmed and burning, keep your lamps. Trimmed and burning, for this old witch is almost done. For this old witch is almost done.
So I first heard the Master do this song on the Rolling Thunder Review Tour, which I think was 1974, might have been 1975. Yeah. Anyway, this song, I've always loved it. Nobody feels any pain. Tonight has a stand inside the rain. Everybody knows baby's got new clothes, but lately I see a ribbon and her bows have fallen from her curls. She takes just like a woman. Yeah, she aches just like a woman. Yeah, she does. And she makes love just like a woman. But she breaks just like a little girl. Queen Mary, she's my friend. I believe, well, I'd go see her again. Nobody has to guess, my baby can't be blessed till she sees finally she's like all the rest. With her gold, her amphetamine, and her curls, she takes just like a woman. Yes, she does. And she aches just like a woman. Yeah. And she makes love just like a woman. But she breaks like a little . It was raining from the first, and I was dying there of thirst. So I came in here
your long-time curses. But what's worse is his painted head. Can't stand it here. Ain't it clear that I just can't fit? I believe that it's time for us to quit. And when we meet again, introduced as friends, please don't let on that you knew me when I was hungry and was young. Well, she tastes just like a woman, and she aches just like a woman. Yes, she does. And she makes love just like a woman, but she breaks like a little girl.
I want to send this next one out to my really good friends, Patty and Jeffrey Norman. Patty requested this song, I don't know, a month or two ago. And I hadn't played it so long, I'd like forgotten about it. And it's such a great song.
She had ribbons in her long blonde hair. I don't know, maybe it was the roses. All I know, I could not leave her there. I don't know, it must have been the roses. The roses are ribbons in a long blonde hair. Maybe it was the roses. All I know, I could not leave her there. 10 years was row the ship so from the sea, thinking well how it may blow in all good company. If I tell another what your own lips told to me, let me nay beneath the roses till my eyes no longer see. Must have been the roses, roses on a ribbon in a long blonde hair. I don't know, maybe it was the roses. All I know, I could not leave her there. One pane of glass in the window, No one is complaining, no, come in and shut the door. Faded is the crimson, the ribbons that she wore. And it's strange how no one comes round anymore. It must have been the roses. The roses on the river in a long blonde hair. I don't know. Maybe it was the roses. All I know, I could not leave her there. Annie laid her head down in the roses. She had ribbons in her long blonde hair. I don't know, maybe it was the roses. I could not leave her there. I don't know, it must have been the roses. Roses on the river in a long blonde hair. Maybe it was the roses. All I know, I could not leave her there. Lovers will marry our fortunes together. I've got some real estate here in my bag. So I bought a pack of cigarettes, Mrs. Wagner, and walk off to look for America. Kathy, I said as I boarded a Greyhound in Pittsburgh. Michigan seems like a dream to me now. It took me 4 days to hitchhike from Saginaw. Now I've come look for America. Laughing on the bus, playing games with the faces. She said the man in the gabardine suit was a spy. I said, be careful, his bow tie is really a camera. Toss me a cigarette, I think there's one in my raincoat. We smoked the last one an hour ago. She read her magazine and the moon rose over an open field. Kathy, I'm lost, said though I knew she was sleeping. I'm empty and I'm making and I don't know why. Counting the calls on the news, just they'll all come. Look for America. All come, look for America. All come, look for America.
So tonight, I guess, is the beginning of the baseball season, such as it is. Our team, that is to say, Jason and my team, which are these two guys down here, the Phillies and the Mets, get started tomorrow. And I have mixed feelings. They've really messed with the rules, and they've done so in ways that I personally find offensive. But I like baseball a lot, so I suspect I will adjust. But I am going to feel bad about it. And I just want you to know. Anyway, I want to sing these next two songs for Jason's mom because, you know, I know she likes the Beatles, but what she really likes is Elvis. And when I was born in 1956, and the song at the moment when I was born was Hound Dog. And there was a Swedish, young Swedish woman who was going to grad school, I think, in our town for like a year. She may have been doing gap year before grad school, but to cover room and board, she took care of baby me. And she was really, really into Elvis. And here's the thing. Ann and I went and visited her in Sweden when I got out of graduate school, right before we got married. And she took me aside and said, I have a confession to make. And Ann was there too. She wanted Ann to hear. She said, look, I was young, and now I run nursing for this entire, the equivalent of a state in Sweden, so this huge area, lots of hospitals. She goes, I feel so guilty. When you were a baby, whenever you cried, I fed you bacon. And I gotta be honest with you, I truly love bacon, and I've always loved bacon, and so apparently it's because of her. And she said, the other thing, I played Elvis like 24 hours a day, and that caused me to realize something amazing, because when I was about 6 or 7 or 8 years old, you know, Elvis was having one of his periodic comebacks, and I realized I knew the words to a huge number of Elvis songs. They were like imprinted in my DNA, and apparently that was all from her. Anyway, I'm going to play a couple of those songs. You know, these are not the top of the charts for Elvis by any stretch. These are just two songs he happened to do. They're two that I was able to work up quickly.
Well, I get out of bed, wash my face and hands. Well, I get out of that bed, wash my face and hands. Well, I get in the kitchen, make me some noise with pots and pans. Well, I believe in my soul, I'm the devil in nylon hose. I believe in my soul, I'm the devil in nylon hose. For the harder I work, the faster my money goes. Well, that's a shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Well, you gon' do right. Save your goddamn soul. You like the one-eyed cat peeping in a seafood stall. You're like a one-eyed cat peeping in a seafood stall. When you look at me, you know I ain't no child no more. Well, I believe you done me wrong, you done me wrong. wrong, now I know. Well, I believe you're doing me wrong. You're doing me wrong, and now I know. 'Cause a hunter I would, faster my money goes. I said, shake, rattle, and roll. Shake, rattle, and roll. Said, shake, rattle, and roll. Said, shake, rattle, and roll. Well, don't you rap to save your doggone soul. I went over the hill, way down underneath. Well, I went over the hill, way down underneath. I make my eyes roll, make line, grip my teeth. Well, I said, shake, rattle, and roll. Shake, rattle, and roll. Shake, rattle, and roll. Rattle and roll. Well, I can do what it wants, get my doggone soul. Well, I can do what I want, save my doggone soul.
The issue with that song and with this next one is the words are just so incredibly misogynistic that, well, actually, this next one's not so bad, but that one, the words are just awful, and so I had to change them all. I hope you don't mind. I mean, I just changed it from saying you to me, you know. But you got to do that because it's like, I mean, I like the song, but I don't like what it says, so I change what it says. So this is a song that Edwin Alice Pete sings.
Oh, that's alright, mama. That's alright for you. That's alright, mama. Just anything you do, well, that's alright. That's alright. That's alright, mama. Hey, anything you do. Oh, mama, she done told me, papa done told me too. Son, that gal you're fooling with, she ain't no good for you. But that's all right, that's all right. That's all right now, mama, anything you do. Oh, leaving town, mama, leaving town for sure. Then you won't be bothered me hanging around your door. Well, it's alright. That's alright now. That's alright now, mama. Anyway, you do. Now you won't be bothered with me hanging around your door. That's alright. That's alright. That's alright, mama. Anything you do. Oh, that's alright, mama. That's alright with you. That's alright, mama. Just any way you do that. That's alright. That's alright now. That's all right now, mama, anyway you do. Well, that's all right, mama, anyway you do.
So I'm going to finish up with one of the first folk songs that I learned, probably after This Land Is Your Land. This is probably the next one, which is cool because when I learned it, it was brand new. So again, tomorrow we're going to have a quartet show, 4:20 p.m. per usual. We're going to try some new songs. Very excited about that. We've been, back together long enough that the repertoire is expanding again. And then Saturday at 4 p.m., so unusual time, it'll be Los Lobos, and they will be doing a live concert, brand new material, brand new, or at least a brand new concert for Hardly Strictly Bluegrass, and you can watch it here if you wish. And that'll be 4 o'clock on Saturday. That would be Pacific time. On Sunday, I think, I'm not actually sure whether it's Jason or me on Sunday. Monday, it'll be the duo. Tuesday, the quartet again. And we'll figure the rest of it out as we're going along. Anyway, thank you all very much for watching. We hope you have a great, great evening tonight. And enjoy the beautiful weather. And please stay well, okay? And we'll talk to you soon. And play ball.